Who designs plants like that? No one. Except us.
In this video, I will show you why the GREET model is such a huge catalyst for Gevo and a potential game changer for the whole biofuel industry. In September, Gevo teamed up with the US Department of Energy and the Argonne National Laboratory to apply the lab scientific GREET model. Using data provided by Gevo, the Argonne lab will test just how low the carbon footprint of a net zero plant is. Even Argonne's own scientists are thrilled by this new partnership, and the results from these tests should be announced very soon. Another scientist at Argonne, U Sung Lee, says if the results are as good as Gevo believes, it will be a game changer in the biofuel industry. Yes, that's right. A game changer in the whole industry. And that would give Gevo a unique selling point.
Argonne, they've been at this a really long time, decades. So the Argonne National Laboratory GREET model is, I think, the gold standard for doing life cycle emissions, life cycle sustainability. It's a life cycle inventory analysis tool. And what it does is it tracks emissions throughout the whole of a business chain, all the way from, in our case, we're interested in where did your carbon come from as a raw material? How was it grown? What happened at agriculture? What happened at a plant? What was the kind of energy? What were the products? You know, how did it get to market? What was the transportation involved throughout the whole chain? And then it burned, and you measure all that, add it up. A company like us, we're making money by defossilization, literally. Net zero one is unusual because of the levers and how we're doing this integration of energy into the process. Who designs plants like that? No one. Except us.
Earlier this year, the US government launched the Net Zero World Initiative, a new partnership with foreign countries to accelerate the global transition to net zero emissions. This initiative is led by the DOE, and the countries committed will cooperate with DOE's national laboratories, such as Argonne, to create and implement highly tailored actionable technology roadmaps and investment strategies that put net zero within reach. According to the US Secretary of Energy, Jennifer Granholm, the partnering nations will harness the power and expertise of the national laboratories. And since Argonne may have a game changer in their lab, the World Net Zero Initiative may create new business opportunities for Gevo.
At the Department of Energy, we have the solutions to tackle our climate emergency. We have the tools to put America on an irreversible path to achieve net zero carbon emissions by 2050. So let's get to work.
The Sustainable Aviation Fuel Grant Challenge is the result of a collaboration between the US Departments of Energy, Transportation, and Agriculture. The goal here is to develop a comprehensive strategy to scaling up new technologies to produce SAF on a commercial scale. This MOU is an ambitious government-wide commitment to scale up the production of SAF to 35 billion gallons per year by 2050. So how is Gevo involved in all of this?
The Sustainable Aviation Fuel Grant Challenge. This is something that's been initiated by the White House. How will Gevo be involved?
I got invited to that meeting, which was a great opportunity. And we had a whole bunch of secretaries, cabinet members there. The Secretary of Energy called upon me and asked the question, how low do you think you could make the carbon footprint of SAF? And of course, then I had the opportunity to explain then, if we replace the fossil energy from the electric grid with wind, renewables, and replace the heat source and get rid of the methane, the fossil-based natural gas, you can actually drive this down to a net zero using the DOE's Argonne GREET model. And so that's what is possible to do, and even go beyond net zero. That is possible to do. You know, if I was going to get a question, that's what I want, that one.
I think we upset some of our competitors sometime because we believe in full transparency of it, just laying it all out there in the open and say, here's what it is, and accounting for it. In fact, we intend to put it to blockchain is what we want to do. Everybody, I think, is familiar enough about blockchain to know that you can attach data and it gets immutable and you can't be messing with it. So yeah, we'll have it audited. It'll be transparent. That's how we think it should be done. But we are going to make money by defossilization, getting rid of it and accounting for it and proving it.
So if the GREET results are as good as Pat says, it would mean that their net zero plans are unique and this would put Gevo in a very strong market position, leaving their competitors trailing. Of course, it's a huge catalyst for the stock as well, and the best of all, we won't have to wait for so much longer. The results should be official within the next few weeks. And if you have ever wondered why Pat Gruber always seems so confident and excited about what Gevo has going on, well, then I hope this video gave you the answer. If you like this video, please hit the like button and make sure to subscribe to my channel. I promise to return soon with more due diligence on Gevo. Please keep in mind, I'm not a financial advisor. I make videos for entertainment purposes only. Until next time, bye bye.